What's shaking, everybody? It's your boy King of the Gold State coming at you with a comic haul I got from a little over a week ago and presenting it to you guys, actually. One of the books, definitely right in front of you. It's a Doctor Strange Treasury Edition, and this sucker's huge. And this might be my second treasury I got in my collection. My first one is the Superman Treasury Edition. It's where he's going through the Fortress of Solitude. This reprints a bunch of little stories from like back in the day. So stuff by Frank Bruner, Steve Ditko, Stan Lee, and so forth. So the sale I went to, some sort of warehouse that I went to, and where like a lot of books were $1. Some books I found, some books I missed out on, and some I just came across, like for example this one. So before I go any further, be sure to like this video, comment down below, also subscribe as well, tell me what you guys think, and if you already subscribed to it, share with your friends who haven't subscribed. So yeah, without further ado, let's get things rolling. For example, like I said, myself and a friend of mine, we went to hit this comic sale, and you know, had a bunch of dollar comic books, you know, some of them were worth more than $1. And one of them I found was a Doctor Strange, a Marvel Treasury Edition. So I was pretty stoked to get this one. You know, now I just gotta know where to put it. But running right through them. Stuff I went to. I added this here, Avengers number 178. It's a first appearance of the Manipulator. Got a Batman 424, which is pretty cool to have. I'm not real familiar with this exact issue. I think there's a certain significance of it. I think it's like the second appearance of Tim Drake in the Robin costume, so you know, don't correct me on that one. Pretty cool to find that. That was X-Factor 24. That's the first appearance of Archangel. Don't get it twisted with anybody else saying it's gonna be like some, it's like some sort of like, you know, other special appearance of Archangel or some other cameo. This is first appearance of Archangel. This one has kind of got a couple of spine ticks on the side, but other than that, I couldn't say no. You know, like everybody was kind of like going fast and furious trying to go dig through these boxes and grab something before I would. Like, found this in one of the boxes, Uncanny X-Men 184. That's a newsstand. Is this other one a newsstand? Nope, direct. So that one's a newsstand. First appearance of Forge. I was in good shape. This one was in okay shape. You know, you can never turn away from something like this one. Uncanny X-Men 201. That's a the fight for who's going to lead the X-Men between Cyclops and Storm. And this one is a newsstand as well. And this one's not in the greatest shape. It probably use a cleaning and such. And you know, it's been loved a couple of times. Got a dog ear or two on the bottom. But you know, whatever. I couldn't say no. Those ones that I just wanted to pick up. I guess this is becoming a thing now. So I found two copies of Exterminators. Number one, that's the, I believe it's the first WizKid who's supposed to be in the Shang-Chi movie. Also the first appearance of Rusty Collins, you know, from the New Mutants back in the early day. For the longest time, I gotta say guys, for the longest time, nobody cared about Exterminators. Everyone who was hunting for books and flipping through books, flipped past this, and now it's like, all of a sudden, this is like a kind of a heating up type of book. Definitely a spec book for sure. I mean, this is one you know, if you come across it in the dollar bin, just put it aside, pick it up, put it aside. If it does something, then cool, you're able to get something, you know, for $1, maybe even cheaper. I mean, these things, you know, it cracks me up when it comes to speculation talk, you know, like everyone's saying, you know, for example, like, here's a good example. For the longest time, Batman 1 through 88, no one really cared about. And all of a sudden, Batman 89 shows up and everybody's losing their minds. It's like, is this the most hilarious thing sometimes? Comics are fickle. Same thing like what I said with Exterminators. This thing, no one cared about for the longest time. And now there's movie talk about what character WizKid going to be next. And now people are picking this up at an insane rate. I think I already have this, but I just like picking this up. It's Wonder Woman 97. It's a really cool Brian Bolland cover. You know, you just can't get enough of Brian Bolland's work, you know, when it comes to like Batman or Wonder Woman or what have you. So, speaking of which, Batman, the movie adaptation, and this is like the deluxe issue. I think there's, I picked this up for a dollar because why not? It's a dollar. But I think there's like a certain significance of copies of the Batman movie adaptation. So if anybody knows, please put it down in the comment section below. Let me know. I think it has something to do with like a first printing or what have you, but I don't know. I'll have to find out later. Punisher back to school special. You know, I just like, whether it's like Punisher going to school or back to school special, whatever, it doesn't matter. I just like a Bill Sienkiewicz cover, and this is a really sick Sienkiewicz cover. Never did the interiors, so it's all right. I mean, this is one you always have to have like a pile of comics you want to put aside for like signatures at a con one day, and this might be one of those books I put aside. So definitely that was pretty cool to get for a dollar. X-Force number one, yeah, it's Liefeld, big deal, but it's X-Force number one, and it's got the Deadpool card in there, and I think the Deadpool card goes for a little bit more than the other X-Force issues, so, you know, as soon as I saw that, I had to get it. Also picked up Batman. This is not having to do with the Spectre, but of course, the first appearance, Vesper Fairchild, character being played by news anchor Rachel Maddow in the Batwoman TV show. So for a dollar, you know, you just don't turn it down. I already have a copy, but I figured why not get another since it's sitting there. This one is Gen 13 number 12. It's your classic J. Scott Campbell cover back in the day when he wasn't able to put comics out on time, which, you know, the fact he's doing covers kind of helps though, as opposed to doing interiors, because, you know, a lot of these artists who do, like, you know, who are trying to do both interiors and covers never seem to put stuff out in time. Namely, James Scott Campbell is one of those guys. So it's pretty cool to see that sitting there for a buck. Also found a Dakota North Investigations. I still picked this up, and I'm not sure if they're still doing a TV show for ABC for it. I'm still waiting on any big word, so we'll have to wait and see on that one. Also, found an Iron Man 220. Second appearance of the Ghost. First appearance, of course, is in 219. Newsstand. Kind of pretty cool newsstand. Another J. Scott Campbell cover. Marvel Comics Presents. I don't know if it does anything special. I just figured I'd pick it up. Picked up, I've been meaning to read this, but American Carnage 3, 2, and 1. I just, you know, I like Vertigo stuff, so it's really cool to see them sitting around in a box for a dollar, you know, each. So, couldn't say no to that, especially since they were sitting there. And, you know, I don't know if I want to pay full price. Marvel Team Up number 117 has Spider-Man Wolverine. He's in pretty good shape. Nice Bob Layton, Joe Rubenstein cover, you know, so picked that up. Also picked up a Heroes for Hope, X-Men. I got more than one copy of this, so I just need to find a time to, like I said, put this in a pile where it's going to get signed by the artist of the cover, and, you know, go from there. You know, because right now, with everything going on in the world, I figured, no rush. So I put those books aside. Found two copies of Ghost Rider, the second print. I can never say no to, you know, something like this when they're a dollar. I mean, you would think this book would be worth a lot more, and, you know, I mean, it is a second print, but unfortunately, it's just, you know, I mean, it's a glow-in-the-dark cover, yeah, it's a gimmick cover, but still, as far as gimmicks, this is definitely one of my favorite gimmicks of the 90s, was the glow-in-the-dark Ghost Rider cover, because just once you turn off all the lights and it glows in the dark, it's pretty cool. Another thing, speaking of cool, was Ghost Rider 15, the regular first print. But also, it was a newsstand. While I was rebagging and boarding, I didn't realize that this was a newsstand I picked up. So I was pretty stoked to see that. Like a newsstand variant of Ghost Rider 15, glow-in-the-dark cover. It's still glow-in-the-dark. Pretty cool. Also found Excalibur number 86, first Pete Wisdom. Found a Captain America 307. That's also a first appearance of Madcap. Found Next Men 14. That's first, I guess, his first technical appearance. Hellboy, people. I guess this book still goes for like $20. It's ridiculous to me, in my opinion, but, you know, I found that. Also, 4341. This is the significance of this issue is it's got like a three panel appearance of Clark Kent. in Lois Lane. So, you know, they, you know, it's in the middle of the comic. They bump into Thor when he's in his regular Donald Blake identity, which is kind of hilarious. If you open this up, you know, you look inside, you see Thor as Donald Blake, who clearly looks like Thor with glasses, which is hilarious. And he bumps into another guy with glasses known as Clark Kent, quote unquote. So it's pretty funny. So stand up there for, you know, for a buck. Also, this is one I gotta take out the bag and board. And I don't know, I put a question up there on Instagram as far as like if anybody knows, but I'm starting to suspect that this is what I think it is as far as what I saw. But this is New Mutants number one, special edition, of course. And I was just rebagging and boarding. I like to open these up and see if there's anything on the interior pages. And lo and behold, I find that, you know. And of course, the numbers on the bottom usually indicate the date that person signed it. So at first, I thought it was Chris Claremont. That was my first thought for a second. Maybe it's an early Chris Claremont signature before he changed everything. But I looked deeper, and it turns out it might be an Arthur Adams signature, like an early Arthur Adams signature, because he likes to write like the date of when he signed stuff. So I'm leaning towards that. So it was pretty cool. This one's pretty, you know, nifty shape for a dollar. You know, couldn't say no. Special. I didn't even look in the book. That's the thing. I didn't look inside the, the comic before I bought the book. I just bought stuff on a whim. And like I said, just opening stuff up and then closing it up, you know, and then going through them when I got home made sense. So, you know, I was pretty fortunate to find something like that. So I think that's signed by Art Adams, like an early Art Adams signature. Also found, a couple other things. We got New Mutants, found a New Mutants Annual number one. Cool, Bill Sienkiewicz cover. First appearance of Lila Cheney. So that was pretty cool. Also, I was able to find this out there too. Thundercats number one, first appearance of the Thundercats. So I was, you know, pretty stoked to find that. Also found these in there as well. X-Men number four, first full appearance of Omega Red. So one of them in the newsstand. So definitely gonna look to get one of these out to, you know, one or all three out to Rocket Comics, get pressed and maybe signed by Jim Lee and slabbed and so forth and the whole nine yards. So that was all I picked up from the $1 sale. It's like a warehouse sale. I was at like a little over a week ago. Also decided to hit the flea market. Actually, no, back up. Also decided to hit a comic shop later on in the day. I was just kind of like, I was going to take a nap, but I didn't feel like sleeping. So I decided to hit a comic shop later in the day and pick up a few other things like Doctor Strange, Mystic Hands Doctor Strange. Number one, so got these for like $5 each. Nice Perillo cover, you know. So that gives me, I think, three copies of this. So that's pretty cool. Picked up a forgot what the significance was, but this is supposed to be a warm book. Blue Beetle number three. Found that sitting in the comic shop. Also found a Ghost Rider number one. It's kind of funny because I got one in the mail a couple days prior of Ghost Rider number one from somebody who was selling it. I forgot who I bought it off of. God, I'm drawing a blank. Somebody's either on Instagram or Facebook sold me one, and then of course found the other one there. But I went for a while not finding one of those, and all of a sudden I found two in a week, which is just weird. Comics are, like I said, comics are weird. Also found a X-Men 221. That's a first appearance of Mr. Sinister, and also found a G.I. Joe number two cover B. That's the Adam Hughes variant. So that was I really love this one. As I think it's my second copy actually, because I've been meaning to get one of them signed by Adam Hughes. So I'm still waiting for that opportunity. It would have gone to like Emerald City Comic Con, but given what's been going on there lately, I'm just going to have to wait until there's another opportunity. So Definitely looking forward to getting this thing signed. I personally don't like the other one where it's kind of sideways and she's kind of, you know, and the rest of the covers are wrapped around. I mean, it doesn't do anything for me as a, you know, somebody who likes to get something slabbed. I like a good full picture, full frontal, basically. So, yeah, it was pretty cool finding that over there at the comic shop. All right, so one last thing, guys. Went to the flea market, decided to hunt around there, and found some pretty nifty stuff. I only spent $10 for the stuff I got from the flea market, which is great. Going to the flea markets is awesome. Found a Magic number 2, number 3, and a number 4. All in some great shape. Yeah, like I said, all together, $10. And I already have a Magic number 1, so I just really wanted to just complete the run. I think I bought a Magic number 1 a couple months ago, and I was wanted to finish up this run and just sit back and read it, since, you know, the Magic character, you know, Ileana Rasputin, is starting to pick up some kind of steam based on the New Mutants movie coming around the corner pretty soon, so pick that up. I also found another copy of Avengers Children's Crusade. You know, I think I'm finding out to be easier and easier to find that copy or that particular issue. Found a Deadpool second appearance for X-Force number 2. That was, you know, for a cheap buck. Another second appearance. Found a DC Comics Presents Superman and Supergirl. That's the second appearance, a Mongol. At first, I thought this was the first, but I was kind of like, eh, whatever. So they were pretty clean covers. Also found in Inhumans number 1. I keep finding this damn thing. It's hilarious. But it's kind of cool to find. I'm not going to complain. Found a pretty decent copy of Young Avengers Presents Hawkeye. This book could use a press and a cleaning, you know, based on the fact it's all, you know, white cover. I wasn't going to put it back, especially when the entire total came out to $10. Like, being it's a whole white cover, it's got some dirt here on the side, and could use a good press and clean and, you know, go from there. So I think that's like my... If I'm holding up on the count, I think it's like my third or fourth copy. So, yeah, definitely was happy to find that. Also, found a Guardians of the Galaxy number 23. That's the Origins of the Symbiotes. So, pretty cool to find that, you know, for the cheap price I got. And I always seem to find... Well, the rule of thumb for me when it comes to Spawn stuff is if it's in a low 200s, pick it up. Look it up later, you know, especially if you're getting it for cheap. So nice cover homage here of what's his face, Frank Miller's Wolverine. So I just thought it was pretty cool to see that sitting in there. So, you know, when it's cheap, get it. So also found this in there. Now you guys are probably wondering what the significance is of this, but this is Amazing Heroes number 35. It goes for like $40 or so, and it's a it has a preview. It has like a small preview of the Amazing Spider-Man black costume. So, you know, whenever you see these fanzines are always good to get. You know, getting the early fanzines, don't skip on those. They're, you know, always got some good stuff. Here's another one to put the rule in mind, and this is pretty much it for the video, but Fallen Son, Death of Captain America. What's wrong with this picture? Well, the guy sold it to me thinking it was a regular cover, which I thought was pretty cool. I'm not going to say no. You know, it's a sketch cover. Yeah, it's got some spine ticks, whatever. I didn't care about that. But the fact is, it's a sketch cover, and I think he thought it was a regular cover. And it's the sketch covers by Lionel Francis Yu, which I thought, oh, wow, that's hilarious. So I took it up to him, you know, and he just gave me a price. All these for $10, and I was like, okay, that's cool. I mean, that's fine. So it was, you know, I was pretty stoked. So now I got that's my second sketch cover of Lionel Francis Yu's work. The first one, of course, is not too far away from me, actually. It's that one here, and is the Wolverine and Jean Grey, you know, which I thought, man, I thought that this would be the only Lionel Francis Yu sketch cover I get from him, and I forgot what I paid for this. I honestly can't remember, but this one, yeah, definitely less than 10, or pretty much on its own probably less than 10, but I think he must have really thought it was a regular sketch, like a regular comic cover, but didn't flinch, had to let it go, had to do it. But that's it, guys. I got no more. I'm going to sit back and call it a night. I'll talk to you guys later. You know the deal. Be sure to hit the like, comment down below. Also, subscribe. And also, if you have subscribed, be sure to tell your friends so they can subscribe. Share this video, guys, okay? I'll talk to you guys later. Peace.